From the modest beginnings of a Dera Dubai tyre shop in 1976, he now runs a company with operations in 65 countries across the Middle East, Africa, Europe, Asia and North America. Today we will be talking to Surinder Singh Gandhari and his wonderful wife, Gurinder Kaur Gandhari, about their lives, their thoughts and their aspirations. So welcome to today's show. Waheguru Ji Ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji Ki Fateh. Gandhari Sahib Ji, first of all, just tell me, welcome to the UK and welcome to the Akal Channel. Tell me why you have come to the UK this time.
We are very fortunate this time. Our trip to UK has been this British Sikh Association is giving us an award for Seva and for the service we have done for the Sikh community in Dubai. And Mr. Rami Ranger, who is the chairman of the British Sikh Association, he's kindly invited us and nominated me to get the award. Mm. We're very proud that we're getting this award because this is an award not for me only, it's for the entire Sikh community of UAE and the Sindhi community of UAE who have been a long time saying their prayers, doing all their hard work and supporting us in building the first Gurdwara in the Middle East.
Mm. And of course, that's another, I mean, most people know you through your work in establishing this beautiful Gurdwara in Dubai, and you know, rather rehearsing all the kind of details, what was it that inspired you to actually take on such an amazing undertaking?
We practiced the Sikh religion in Dubai since we came to Dubai in 1976. We had a small Gurdwara in our home, but as they always say, Sangat and Pangat in Sikhi, we wanted to promote that, so we started having congregations in smaller warehouses, smaller places of small halls available, but it was not very convenient to everybody. Mm-hmm. Because the Sangat started increasing. The numbers are today, we have 50,000 Sikhs living in the UAE and 40,000 Sindhis who believe in Guru Nanak Dev Ji.
So, 50 plus 40, so it's 90,000.
90,000 people living in the UAE who believe in Guru Nanak Dev Ji and his teachings. So the need was there about 11 years ago. For us to officially approach the UAE government to get permission to build the first Gurdwara. It took us a long time to convince the Islamic Affairs Committee in Dubai about Sikhism. I did some translations of Guru Granth Sahib in Arabic and presented to them. And one fine day, Sheikh Mohammed bin Rashid Al Maktoum, the Vice President and Prime Minister of UAE and the ruler of Dubai, was very kind, very generous, to give us permission to build the first Gurdwara. Also, he gave us 25,400 square feet of land free for the Sikh community of UAE. Mm-hmm. His conditions were very simple. He wanted an iconic piece, wanted the best Gurdwara in the world, and he wanted us not to enter into any politics and not have any issues like forming a committee and having political situation. We adhered to both his requests. We built the most modern Gurdwara in the world, and we're very proud about it.
That's fantastic. If I can come to Pandy as well, and I'm sure you are also proud. And Gandhi, behind every successful man, there's a very, very vibrant and powerful woman. So welcome to the show today. Pandy, first of all, I know that you are lovingly referred to as Bubbles. So tell me, your real name is Gurinder Kaur. So Bubbles kitho aa gaya thoda naam?
I don't know, according to people, maybe it's the personality, they say that I'm bubbling all the time. But, you know, in Punjabi, most of the girls, some of the girls are normally called commonly bubbly. Bubbly to bubble ho gaya, bubble to bubbles ho gaya.
Okay.
And,
so
that's like how it stuck on to me.
Now tell me, we've heard about how the Gurdwara was established. Do saal ho gaye hum Gurdwara chalde na?
Teesra saal.
So, tell me about the success, the achievements.
The achievements as in the popularity of the Gurdwara?
In every regard.
Yeah. Well, it was something that people had never even thought they would be able to see a Gurdwara, the light of the day. Mm-hmm. In fact, when it was being built also, there was a lot of people thinking, well, it's never going to be, it's again one of those attempts, futile attempts. Magar is tarah nahi si, guys. Iswari Guruji was really mehrban and everything went well, and now we have every day the Sangat is increasing by the day.
Yeah.
We have like 1,000 people every day coming to do their prayers and langar chakke jande hage, and every Friday, which is a holiday like a Sunday over here, there's about 10,000 people. Or agar Gurpurab hoye te, about 40,000 people are there. So, which is a great feeling. Mm. And it's not just Sikhs. We have people from different communities that come.
Mm-hmm.
And they come, they pray, they sit there. We have a hall which is meant for har banda jo bhi aaye, apne mazhab da hoye, apna paath karna hoye, apni prayer karne hoye, they are welcome to do it. So we do not restrict ourselves to that.
I've heard that it's become a bit of a tourist attraction as well.
I would say the Dubai Gurdwara is now a destination Gurdwara for weddings. We already had more than 100 weddings in the Gurdwara in the last 3 years. And it's become a big tourist attraction. In fact, it is now in the Dubai tourist map, an iconic place to visit.
Beautiful, yeah.
And we are very proud that today, even visitors who come to Dubai, who are not Sikhs, they want to come and visit the Gurdwara.
Okay. And any plans for the future, for expansion or to, you know, any thoughts that maybe you need more than one? I mean, if you've got 100,000 Sikhs just in Dubai.
I'm sure the government of Dubai may grant us, but I'm not sure. Because for them to give us this piece of land and allow us to build the Gurdwara was a big,
very magnanimous gesture
on their part.
Benji, I know that Sikhs are a minority mostly everywhere they go. Even in Punjab, it feels like now we are a minority. And the only way that minorities can survive is if you really develop a love for the local communities where you live.
Absolutely.
And it seems to me that this because there was some fear that this Gurdwara might create some tensions, but actually it's on the opposite, hasn't it? And I heard about something around the Eid festival that there was some phenomenal kind of a community engagement. Tell me about that.
Absolutely. You see, we actually first, they invited Surinderji, which is in itself a great thing because that's recognizing another religion besides Islam and Christianity.
Mm-hmm.
And they asked him to give a speech in the mosque, which was unheard of ever in an Islamic country. And that was on interfaith.
Mm-hmm.
So we had to actually explain to them how Islam and Sikhism have so many things in common. And that went a very great way with them. So they came over to the Gurdwara. This was during the Ramadan time. The first Friday, which is a very auspicious day for them, they invited us. And the following Friday, they came over to the Gurdwara and they broke their fast.
Roza din apa ke roza.
Hanji. Roza unhane utthe kholya. Unhane namaz bhi padhi. Ek section unhane baste bana deta si. Unhane apni namaz padke roza kholya sade naal. And they brought some gifts for us, which was just amazing.
Hanji. Main aaj just like this view na share karde ha ki kai wari jado main aap khud us Gurdwara te gaya ta mainu kive idda lagda pe jida Guru Nanak Padshah ji aap hi itthe jidda Middle East vich gaye si na adasiyan ch ਸ਼ਾਇਦ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ ਪਾਤਸ਼ਾਹ ਵੀ ਇੱਥੇ ਹੈ ਹੈ ਤਾਂ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਇਹ ਦੇਖੋ ਕਮਾਲ ਦੀ ਚੀਜ਼ ਆ ਕਿ ਮੁਸਲਮਾਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰੇ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਆ ਕੇ ਵੀ ਆਪਣੀ ਨਮਾਜ਼ ਪੜ੍ਹੀ ਰੱਬ ਦਾ ਨਾਂ ਚੇਤਾ ਕੀਤਾ ਔਰ ਇਹ ਇੰਟਰਫੇਸ ਡਾਇਲੋਗ ਦੇ ਬਾਰੇ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਆਈ ਨੋ ਦੈਟ ਯੂ ਰੀਸੈਂਟਲੀ ਵੈਂਟ ਟੂ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਸਪੈਸ਼ਲ ਇਵੈਂਟ ਇਨ ਅਡਲੇਡ ਇਨ ਆਸਟ੍ਰੇਲੀਆ
ਨੋ ਇਟ ਵਾਸ ਇਨ ਬ੍ਰਿਸਬਨ
ਬ੍ਰਿਸਬਨ ਸੌਰੀ ਇਟਸ ਬ੍ਰਿਸਬਨ ਟੈਲ ਮੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਦੈਟ ਬਿਕਾਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਵਾਸ ਯੂ
ਆਈ ਵਾਸ
ਅੰਬੈਸਡਰ
ਆਈ ਵਾਸ ਆਸਕਡ ਬਾਈ ਦੀ ਯੂਏਈ ਗਵਰਨਮੈਂਟ ਦੀ ਮਿਨਿਸਟਰ ਫਾਰ ਕਲਚਰ ਯੂਥ ਐਂਡ ਕਮਿਊਨਿਟੀ ਡਿਵੈਲਪਮੈਂਟ to represent the UAE government in the interfaith summit, the first interfaith summit of G20 in Brisbane this year. It was just 2 weeks ago, on 16th to 18th of November. And I think it was a great honor for the Sikh community, a great honor for me personally to represent the Sikh community in the interfaith summit in Brisbane. And there were more than 200 delegates from different faiths. We had Baha'is, Jews, Christians, Hindus, Muslims. And I was only one Sikh in the whole congregation. And I was allowed to speak for 12 minutes to speak about Sikhi, to speak about the tolerance of religion in the UAE. And we all got a fantastic ovation for this. And people really appreciated that in an Islamic country, Sikhism is allowed to be practiced freely. And the government is supporting it.
Benji, that's the amazing thing is that Baji went officially under the aegis of the UAE government.
Absolutely.
In effect, he was an ambassador for the UAE. He wasn't there as a Punjabi or as an Indian.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And what are the kind of relationships like with the authorities in Dubai and the Sikh community? And because you're kind of working quite closely at that level.
Yeah, it's very, very favorable. And the whole tolerance part from them and the way whatever, we need, like now we are planning to do, open up a children's classes that we have there, they know about it and they're quite happy that, you know, go ahead and do these things. And in fact, when he came, Sheikh Nayan, the minister we are talking about, he came for Guru Nanak Dev Ji's Gurpurab.
Mm-hmm.
And the speech he gave was so beautiful and so informative, but it made every Sikh proud, because he not only spoke about Guru Nanak Dev Ji's ideologies and his preachings, like Naam Japna, Kirat Karna, and Vanchakna, he knew all that, and he said, we are practicing, we as Muslims in this country, or even the citizens, all the citizens of this country, practice Guru Nanak Dev Ji's preachings. And he went to Guru Gobind Singh Ji, and he said that Guru Gobind Singh Ji took the sword only as a last resort, which was amazing for him to say that.
Of course, I mean, Kabir Ji da shabd mein da ved kateb koho mat jhutha jhutha jo na bichare. And so Kabir Ji, aap kya bhi jide veda si hinduwan de granth ja kateb sige jide ki Abrahamic religions which Quran Sharif bhi aa janda utthe Bible bhi aa jandi hai aur guru bani de vich kya bhi eh sach hai. But I know that you presented him with this plaque where you juxtapose the Mul Mantar with equivalent verses from Quran Sharif. And the amazing thing was the meanings were just resonating with each other.
Absolutely, absolutely. Mm. And that was quite a thing for them. They had never thought there was so much similarity. It came quite an eye-opener for them, and they really appreciated that. So the speech that Surinderji gave went viral, and it went to Sheikh Muhammad too. And they were all so impressed, which is why one of the reasons that he was chosen to go to G20 summit.
I mean, some Sikhs might object to putting, Gurbani side by side with the writings of the scriptures.
You'll be surprised.
Yeah.
They weren't. They took it very nicely.
Very positive.
Very nicely.
Yeah. Very
they appreciated.
So they didn't feel in any way that...
Not at all.
Because I know that the Muslims are very kind of, protective of the Quran Sharif. And same,
yeah, we were scared too. At the beginning, we were very apprehensive. But they took it so beautifully. In fact, when all our people, when he had gone to the mosque to give the speech, there were a lot of people that had come from the Gurdwara with us, and they were so emotionally charged at the end of the speech that they gave their, Vaheguru Ji ka Khalsa, Vaheguru Ji ki Fateh, and Bole So Nihal.
Yeah.
There was no reaction.
And of course,
they took it so beautifully.
Guru Granth Sahib Ji, which Allah loves ki paranda, Allah na visre, Allah akbar nur pa. Actually, Allah is a word that is using Guru Granth Sahib Ji. And it's really important to remind the Muslims that jira tusi rab nu yaad karde ohi sada rab ya.
Absolutely, the situation is Allah, the word Allah is meant for the eternal God, not for any individual. And eternal God is one. And we believe in one God. Ours is a very monotheistic religion. We believe in one God, and the source Islam also believes in one God, and that God is eternal. Prophet Muhammad, Guru Nanak Dev Ji, Guru Gobind Singh, they were all messengers of God. They were not real gods. That's why when Guru Gobind Singh Ji left this world, he made Guru Granth Sahib the living Guru. And he said, no human being will be the Guru after me, it will be the living Guru. And today the Indian constitution has recognized Guru Granth Sahib Ji as a living Guru also.
Yeah. And the tragedy is that what we've done with the Guru Granth Sahib Ji is we've wrapped it up in cloth, which is fine, but then we've said, it's Sardaya. But actually Guru Arjan Dev Ji, when he brought all the traditions, all the religious teachings of truth, of Sach into one place, it was a grant for the whole of humanity, wasn't it?
Absolutely, absolutely.
Yeah, and there again lies the challenge. And sometimes, Maya Sojdan, interfaith is about sharing, and Sikhi is about sharing. We share practically langar, we share our kamai, but we also share our thoughts and dialogue. And but you need confidence to share. And I sometimes think that Sikhs lack confidence, that jaisi share kite, share thadi faith, we would lose our faith. But
I think now people are changing now. People's thinking is changing now, and people are becoming more broad-minded, because education has one which has helped everybody. Now, if we learn about other religions, we understand their religion, we appreciate their religion. So also they understand our religion, and it's our duty to explain our religion to others, because we are the newest religion in the world. We're only 545 years old, whereas Islam and Hinduism is thousands and thousands of years ago. So it's our duty as Sikhs, we should all support the explanation of Sikhism to every other faith.
Okay, we've been talking about some contemporary issues, and we will, continue to have these discussions. But let me just kind of take us back a bit now, maybe earlier part of your story. Now, I know that you actually were born in India, in Andhra Pradesh, in a place called Vijayawada.
Vijayawada.
Tell me about those beginnings, because, as I said, Baisabhi is a very successful businessman. He works in the tire industry, and he's one of the leading businessmen within that field. We won't talk about wealth, because the real wealth is Bihar, and you have much more wealth in Bihar. But where did it all begin?
You see, I'm the third generation in the tire business. My grandfather started the business in 1942 in Vijayawada. Before the partition, my grandfather, my father, they all moved to Vijayawada and they started the automotive spare part business. My father is the second generation, I'm the third generation. I have two sons, Jajiv and Harjiv, and they are the fourth generation who are taking the business forward. So it's more of a family business. I came to Dubai in 1976 to form an extension of our family business from India.
Now, let me say, because we have another connection, because last year I was a visiting professor at Loyola College in Chennai, and I know that Loyola College, your alma mater of Loyola College yourself.
I was a BCom honors graduate from Loyola Madras. I was also the student union president in 1967. Mm-hmm. And even those, when I was the president, the Pope, the Jesuit Pope, mm-hmm. Father Pedro had visited our college and I had the privilege of hosting him in college as president of the Students' Union. And my love for the religion, love for humanity started at a very young age. Because mm-hmm. my grandfather always was my guiding soul. And he always told me one thing, when you grow up, do something which will leave a good image in the society after you leave the world. Mm-hmm. And when I was 8 years old, he told me, Bachya, ho sake de gurdwara bana de. And that stuck in my mind.
ਜੀ ਬਿਲਕੁਲ ਇਹ ਗੱਲ ਸੱਚਾਈ ਆ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਬਾਬਿਆਂ ਪੜਦਾਦਿਆਂ ਦੀ ਬਾਣੀ ਚ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਯਾਨੀ ਕਿ ਪੁੱਤ ਸਪੁੱਤ ਕਰੇਨ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਆਪਾਂ ਕਹਾਣੀਆਂ ਬਾਣੀਆਂ ਕਹਾਣੀਆਂ ਪੁੱਤ ਸਪੁੱਤ ਕਰੇਨ ਸੋ ਅਸੀਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਕਮਾਈ ਦਾ ਅਸੀਂ ਖਾਂਦੇ ਹਾਂ
ਬਿਲਕੁਲ
ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਜੇ ਜੇ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਲੈਗਸੀ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਦਿੱਤੀ ਆ ਜੇ ਉਹ ਨਾ ਹੋਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਨਾਥਿੰਗ ਸੋ ਆਪਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਦੀ ਖਾਣਾ ਖਾਣੀ ਵੀ ਆ ਪਰ ਅਸੀਂ ਫਿਊਚਰ ਜਨਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਵਾਸਤੇ ਵੀ ਲੈਗਸੀ ਬਣਾਉਣੀ ਆ And it seems like that's the kind of mission that your family is involved in.
In fact,
my grandfather had always told me one thing. Ke, tusi agar seva bhi karni hai, daan bhi karna hai, kadi apna naam na dena kisi. So we don't give our name anywhere. What a seva we do group seva.
But let me ask that. This is a difficult question. Kei badi log kehnde hain ki to banda bahut sarmayedar rehnda. ਬੇਸ਼ੱਕ ਆਪਣੀ ਹੱਥਾਂ ਇੰਡੀਆ 'ਚ ਤਾਂ ਕੋਈ ਘੱਟ ਹੀ ਮਿਹਨਤ ਕਰਕੇ ਪੈਸਾ ਬਣਾਉਂਦਾ ਪਰ ਬਾਹਰ ਤਾਂ ਸਾਨੂੰ ਮਿਹਨਤ ਕਰਕੇ ਬਣਾਉਣਾ ਪੈਂਦਾ
ਬਿਲਕੁਲ
ਪਰ ਫਿਰ ਲੋਕ ਕਹਿੰਦੇ ਜੀ ਇਹ ਸਰਮਾਏਦਾਰ ਆ ਜਾਂ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਚਮਕਾਉਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਆਪਣਾ ਨਾਮ ਰੋਸ਼ਨ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਆਪਣੇ ਆਪ ਨੂੰ ਫੇਮਸ ਕਰਨਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਇਸ ਦਾ ਯੂ ਆਰ ਦ ਕਲੋਸਿਸਟ ਪਰਸਨ ਇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਬਾਈ ਸਮ ਇਜ਼ ਦੈਟ ਹਿਸ ਮੋਟੀਵੇਸ਼ਨ
ਐਬਸੋਲੂਟਲੀ ਨਾਟ ਐਬਸੋਲੂਟਲੀ ਨਾਟ ਐਂਡ ਆਮ ਨਾਟ ਸੇਇੰਗ ਦਿਸ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ ਮਾਈ ਹਸਬੰਡ ਬਟ ਆਈਵ ਸੀਨ ਹਿਮ ਦਿਨ ਰਾਤ ਜਿਸ ਤਰ੍ਹਾਂ ਉਹਨਾਂ ਨੇ ਜੋ ਵੀ ਕੰਮ ਕੀਤਾ ਹੁਣ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਸ਼ੋਭਾ ਨਹੀਂ ਦਿੰਦਾ ਦੈਟ ਹਾਊ ਮਚ ਹਾਰਡ ਹੀ ਇਜ਼ ਵਰਕਡ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਐਜ਼ ਯੂ ਕੈਨ ਅੰਡਰਸਟੈਂਡ ਕਿ ਬਈ ਜਿਹੜੇ ਇਸਲਾਮਿਕ ਕੰਟਰੀ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਗਰ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਬਣਿਆ ਇਟ ਮਸਟ ਹੈਵ ਬੀਨ ਅਗੇਂਸਟ ਸੋ ਮੈਨੀ ਆਡਸ ਐਂਡ ਯੈਸ ਐਜ਼ ਵੀ ਸੈਡ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਕਿੱਥੇ ਵੀ ਨਾਂ ਨਹੀਂ ਲਿਖਦੇ ਹੈਗੇ ਆ ਬਿਕੋਜ਼ ਈਵਨ ਦ ਪੀਪਲ ਵੈਨ ਦੇ ਡੋਨੇਟ ਦੱਸੇ ਕਿ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਨਾਂ ਲਗਾ ਦਿਓ ਸਾਡਾ ਪਲੈਕ ਲਗਾ ਦਿਓ ਇਹ ਕਰ ਦਿਓ ਨੋ ਵੇਅਰ ਇਨ ਦ ਗੁਰਦੁਆਰਾ ਐਂਡ ਐਨੀ ਵਾਲ ਵਿਲ ਯੂ ਫਾਈਂਡ ਦ ਨੇਮ ਆਫ ਐਨੀ ਬਾਡੀ ਇਨਕਲੂਡਿੰਗ ਅਸ
That's
because
amazing.
That's one thing, and because of that, we had to meet with a lot of hardships. Because log kehnde assi ta dena hi nahi ji kuch daan nahi da kuch charity nahi karni the naani kyunki tusi na nahi pa rahe ho. So we said, never mind, so be it. Somewhere Guruji kaam karde and they did it.
I'm the talent. I mean, again, I'm going to embarrass you, but mainu pata pehli tusi aap broadcast kiya, you are aap tusi radio de vich. Tell us about that.
It was a great experience. It was a really nice experience. And I was actually trying to, even over there on the radio, we were trying to promote...
This is Dubai, right?
Hanji. Trying to talk more, educate people more on Punjabi, Gurmukhi. Of course, we wouldn't talk religion at that point.
Yeah.
But even getting them to be aware of
Punjabi
what
culture.
Punjabi culture is, Punjabi music. And I used to actually come to London to pick up the latest numbers so I could play them on the radio over there.
Yeah, yeah.
And that was great.
That's fantastic.
Yeah.
And now we're talking about hidden talents. And, you know, I know that you speak many languages.
Yes.
You're a linguist.
I was born in Vijayawada.
Yeah.
So, by birth of being in Andhra Pradesh, I had to speak Telugu.
Yeah.
I read and write Telugu because that was my second language in school.
Tamil, you must have learned Tamil.
And I went to Madras and I learned Tamil. I worked for a few months in Kerala, so I speak a little bit of Malayalam. And now I pick up a little bit of Arabic. Then we have English and Hindi and Punjabi. So, we have seven languages on my card.
That's amazing. And again, aap paaje comparisons kare bhi Sri Guru Granth Sahib ji. Hai ta Gurmukhi de vich. Jidi Lippi script. But there are many, many languages.
Yes,
and again,
yes.
This idea that we have to become people of the world.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We can't belong to one place.
Absolutely.
And this is essence. I mean, you talk about interfaith dialogue. And this is the essence of the message, isn't it? That we belong to the world.
Yeah.
And when you say jo tu share karde ho dusre din aapko because many people don't know about sikhi
ji
how do they respond
very positively in fact when he went to the G20 summit he was telling me about how the ladies came up to him and said we want to know more about sikhi and he felt so bad that asi koi books nahi lake gaye si to inform them but maybe next year whenever the summit is we will
I'll carry a lot of books with me next time
but you're talking about books I know that you recently met Dr. Aitken as well and there was a project that tell us about that
yeah in fact Dr. Aitken Mr. Kartar Lalwani Mr. Ram Jethmalani and Lord Hamid writing a book on Guru Nanak, which is going to be one of its kind book, written by four different people from Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, Isai. There are four people writing this book, and I'm looking forward to getting the book released soon. It should be ready by in 6 months, they say.
Yeah.
And that will give me an insight of Guru Nanak Dev Ji, insight of Sikhism, which I'm looking forward to it.
And if you remember, I think it's Timothy Akin, his name. He was a former conservative minister who, for legal reasons, he was convicted for telling lies in court. Yeah, anyway, that's but his daughter embraced Sikhi, and he has made amazing attempts to learn about Sikhi, and he's been inspired as well.
Yes.
Therefore, going for this book.
She lives now in Anandpur Sahib.
Hmm.
She's learning how to do kirtan.
Hmm.
She's learning about Sikhi. In fact, I met him yesterday, and I told him I would like to invite her to Dubai, and let us speak about. Sikhi, for a British woman to speak about Sikhi to the population in Dubai, it will be a great service to the Sikhi.
Okay, and of course, you know, jitna Guru Nanak Pasha kena ek baba pair
tere
dooja da babi mardana, theek hai? Bhi ona de jere instruments, ona de technology sikhi ki ek pair sake, ek pyaar saka, ta ek rabab sikhi. ਅੱਜ ਕੱਲ ਦੇ ਯੁੱਗ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਅਸੀਂ ਇੱਕ ਸਕਿੰਟ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਕੈਨ ਗੋ ਫਰਮ ਦੁਬਈ ਟੂ ਲੰਡਨ ਟੂ ਨਿਊਯਾਰਕ ਵਾਇਆ ਦੀ ਨੈਟਵਰਕਸ ਐਂਡ ਮੀਡੀਆ ਇਜ਼ ਅ ਵੈਰੀ ਪਾਵਰਫੁਲ ਟੈਕਨੋਲੋਜੀ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਵਿੱਚ ਐਂਡ ਯੂ ਨੋ ਕਾਲ ਚੈਨਲ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਹਾਂ ਵੀ ਅਸੀਂ ਸਿੱਖੀ ਨੂੰ ਸਾਰੀ ਦੁਨੀਆ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਫੈਲਾ ਦਈਏ ਸੋ ਵਟ ਯੂਅਰ ਥੋਟਸ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਹਾਓ ਵੀ ਆਰ ਔਨ ਆਰ ਨੋਟ ਮੇਕਿੰਗ ਯੂਜ ਆਫ ਨਿਊ ਟੈਕਨੋਲੋਜੀ ਟੂ ਸਪਰੈਡ ਦ ਮੈਸੇਜ ਆਫ ਗੁਰੂ ਨਾਨਕ
ਆਈ ਥਿੰਕ ਦ ਕਾਲ ਟੀਵੀ ਚੈਨਲ has got a fantastic beginning. I wish them all the luck because what they are on the right path. And today, the electronic media can really do a lot of big service to the community, a lot of service to Sikhi. And in any way, I can be of any help, I'll always be forthcoming because I believe strongly that we should propagate our religion to people because there's every goodness in our religion and people are not having knowledge about it. They're misguided about our religion.
Yeah.
And this religion belongs to everyone. It's not just Sikhs and Sikhs alone, or Khalsa as we would call some of them. But Sikhi is a religion of humanity for human beings, for all human beings. And that's what is like Guru Nanak Dev Ji had mentioned, that you can be, he never had the idea of ever converting anybody from their religion to Sikhism. He would say, if you're a good Hindu, be a good Hindu. If you're a Muslim, be a good Muslim, but just be a good human being. And that is the philosophy we would all want to do, spread love, spread harmony.
Bilkul, aur Guru Nanak Pasha Ji, aap kya, jidho puchya gaya se bhi Hindu vada ke Muslim noi. Baba, aapke hajiyan, ਸ਼ੁਭ ਅਮਲਾ ਬਾਜੋ ਦੋਨੋਂ ਰਹੀ ਅਸਲ ਵਿੱਚ ਜੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਸ਼ੁਭ ਅਮਲਾ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਸੋਚ ਨਾਲ ਸੱਚੀ ਹੋਵੇ ਤੁਹਾਡੇ ਕੰਮ ਨਾਲ ਸੱਚੇ ਹੋਣ ਸਿੰਸੈਰਿਟੀ ਨਾ ਹੋਵੇ ਤਾਂ ਤੁਸੀਂ ਦੋ ਹੀ ਤੰਗ ਹੋਵੋਗੇ ਸੋ ਇਟਸ ਅਬਾਊਟ ਕਾਮ ਸਿੰਸੈਰਿਟੀ ਬਟ ਜਸਟ ਫਾਈਨਲੀ ਵੀ ਗੋਟ ਅਰਾਊਂਡ ਅਪ ਵੀ ਹੈਵ ਕਮ ਮਚ ਟਾਈਮ ਐਂਡ ਔਨ ਦ ਮੀਡੀਆ ਆਈ ਮੀਨ ਯੂ ਐਸ ਅ ਯੂ ਇਨਵੋਲਵ ਵਿਦ ਦ ਮੀਡੀਆ ਇਫ ਯੂ ਕੁਡ ਹੈਵ ਸਮ ਡ੍ਰੀਮਸ ਐਂਡ ਵਿਸ਼ਸ ਆਫ ਅ ਸਿੱਖ ਮੀਡੀਆ ਐਂਡ ਦ ਕਾਈਂਡਸ ਆਫ ਵੇਅਰਸ ਇਟ ਮਾਈ ਆਪਰੇਟ ਵਾਟ ਵੁੱਡ ਦੋਸ ਬੀ Because in a sense, we want to follow the dreams of the Sangat who want Sikhi to go for. What would you tell us? What would you demand of us as Nakal channel?
Well, I think for a start, maybe the Hukam Nama starts and you start to explain what that is all about. Or you could do a little bit of Santhya, you know, that the Nitname de Bare which every time maybe do a Sukhmani Saab da ik pad tusi par sakde ho. That way, and then maybe sometimes talk about the 10 Gurus. What was the basic philosophy? How does it go forward? At the same time, with Kirtan, but something that would interest people and not just be a boring sermon, you know. I'm sorry to use that word, but because the youngsters like some... something interesting in them. What we are doing in our Gurdwara, for example, is we have exhibitions on every Gurpurab that is there, like tomorrow, or I mean on the 24th, there is Guru Gobind, Guru Tegh Bahadur Ji's Shahidi Gurpurab. So we will have an exhibition which we put in which we inform the youngsters and elders all alike. In Gurmukhi we write and in English.
Yeah.
So they see the whole thing, and these are the kind of media things that help people.
So Bhaji, what Panji said, beautiful things, that we need to preserve our traditions, apri parampara, but we need to learn the languages, we need to learn the traditional kirtan, but we need to bring it into a modern context. And of course, your daughter-in-law has done some amazing things in this regard in terms of kirtan. Just tell me, and that has had impact across the globe. Young people are inspired.
Yeah.
Tell me about that.
She's done a fantastic job. She's made two CDs now. Mm-hmm. And her style of kirtan is for the young people.
Mm-hmm.
And for modern people to enjoy kirtan. You see, if you, most cars in Dubai and most cars, I think, or in Europe, they all have her CD in the car.
Mm-hmm.
So when the people are driving, they listen to kirtan. The message is very simple. They enjoy the music, but they get the message of peace and love and harmony through the kirtan.
Absolutely, or if I can just take a license by Sabi, he's involved in the motor trade, tyres. If we think about the car, there are two mirrors in the car. There's a mirror, a small mirror above, and two screens. There's a screen at the back and a screen at the front. So we have to look in that mirror to look.
Mm-hmm.
We have to keep looking what's behind, but there's a big screen in the front, but we have to have most of the attention where we're going.
Basically, we should not lose our focus.
Yes.
Our focus has not to be changed, our focus has not to be lost. But look at the big mirror and have to keep one eye on the small mirror too.
No, not to forget our roots.
Benji, I mean, we're going to finish now because I haven't got much time, but you know, you went into what you might call theoretically a very hostile environment, you know, a strong Islamic country. But so what hope have you for the Sikhi's future?
Oh, we have great hopes. If it goes the way it's going, we have great hopes for Sikhi. If the way it's being blossoming around, it's absolutely fabulous because the youngsters are now trying to understand what it's all about. And they are appreciating it. So if we go the normal way and we don't have people who kind of curb you, as you say, over small things and, you know, little rituals that they want, which is not absolute taboo in our religion. If they don't stick to that, which they don't, and you know they are cooperating, at least in Dubai, it's a beautiful feeling, and I feel it's going to all over again come up and flower.
I must add one thing here, sorry.
Yeah.
What I want to add, you know, both of us have been trying to promote Sikhi, and both of us have succeeded, because I have succeeded in one person in my office, who cut off his hair and wanted to become modern. I said, Nay, don't forget your roots. You're a Sikh, be a Sikh. And today he wears a turban, he grows his beard. And she did the same thing in the Gurdwara. We had one sevadar.
Two
sevadars. We made them back into Sikhs. So now they are very proud to be a Sikh.
Yes.
Yeah.
And I always tell people, not only I am proud, I am honored to be a Sikh.
Yeah. And humble too.
Yeah. And of course, that's the last word, Panjihanji.
I just wanted to say, this gentleman he's talking about is one of our office staff, who he had given the letter to him for permission for the Gurdwara. And this gentleman had said, if the permission is granted, I will become a Sikh.
Mm-hmm.
So he was the messenger who took it to the Sheikh's office.
Absolutely.
And so after that, he kept his promise. And he is a proud Sikh today. He's so regular in the Gurdwara, and the most trusted of us. The other two gentlemen also were just staff people who came, you know, ek di pagni si, ek di dadi ni si. Dona ne pago dadi rakhi hai. And it so feels so good when
Absolutely.
You go to see that.
Bilkul, main Bhai Sahib ji ne bahut Panji ne bahut ek soni gal kahi. If we think about it, you know, we spend so much money on designer labels. And why do we do that? To differentiate ourselves, to see ourselves special. Well, Guru Gobind Singh Ji made us into a designer religion.
Absolutely.
We are a designer religion.
Very true. Very true.
And that design label is there, and it's got fantastic brand value. You know, if you talk a business speak, the brand value of the star, we celebrate the 100th anniversary of the Sikh contribution in the world wars. We are talking about the history of the Sikhs. It is a phenomenal brand value, but we don't know our history. And that's got to be another...
We forget our own strengths.
Okay.
We forget our own roots. And I think, you know, I was in the Interfaith Summit in Australia, I was the only Sikh gentleman there with a turban.
Mm-hmm.
And everybody knew me. I didn't know everybody, but everybody knew me because of my turban.
Okay.
And they all wanted to take photographs with me.
Yeah.
I was very proud about that.
Thank you very much. So I've been talking to Surinder Singh Kandari and also Gurinder Kaur Kandari as well from Dubai. They are humble Sikhs with great ambitions for Sikhi. And today just we have had some glimpses of their inspiration and their own commitment. So main thoda da bahut dhanwad karda UK de vich aun te, and I hope that your trip is successful and hopefully we will meet again. So asis fateh bhaiye, Waheguru Ji ka Khalsa, Waheguru Ji ki.